Hi, Kaylana Sidrani on these with another athlete, champion, and one of my heroes. This goes out to for Sarah Gronert, a German professional tennis player that was involved with a gender controversy a year and a half ago. Might have been two or one. I don't remember exactly when. And I'll put some links to some of the news reports and... I haven't really seen too much new information, so I'm hoping she's still around and kicking and doing what she can. apparently, she was born with ambiguous genitalia, and parents, with doctors, advice, thought it would, better for her to be raised as a girl, assigned as a girl, she grew up, lived as a girl, 22-year-old, very beautiful young woman, mature woman, if you want. She still ain't due. Young to me, I'm 39. Not that I'm that old, but... it's... a lot of people, especially people who are competing... athletes are competing against other people are so misinformed about the advantages and disadvantages of being intersexed and the conditions that we may have. A lot of the remarks that were made was that no man can serve like her, no woman serves like that. And I'm thinking, of at least five or six that serve better, faster, quicker, are better tennis players than she is. The Williams sisters. Oh, never mind. I'm not a tennis buff, so I don't remember the names. I can't even think. It doesn't really matter. There are many, many gifted women tennis players who are women. And Sarah Gronert, I don't even remember her place in the rankings. She's not really, far up there. She's within the top 100 or was kind of thing. But that's, somewhere. But she's not like number one or number two or number three, or within the top 10 to my knowledge. Which clearly shows that, no, she can compete, but she doesn't have an advantage that other women don't have, and it's like, I know I've written and commented to, in some of the support groups, when this came out, that it's ridiculous that a woman, is offended or upset that she's competing against an intersex woman. There aren't any advantages, with her condition. She's not any stronger than any other woman is. And it goes for the two runners I've already made videos on. I'm gonna say Cassius Maynard, astounding performance. She might have had an advantage. Don't know, because I don't know about the times about all the other runners. If they were all their best times too, or if they were all their worst times. It could have been that, everyone else saw this runner in front of them, devastate him, and they might have just given up. At the end. And they just don't really know about those things, And I'm curious, and I might actually go back and check the times and start looking at some of, who else won those medals and how well did they run against, some of their better runs. And figure out, was it a totally astounding run, or was it just a totally astounding run against the other athletes that were competing? And I'm going to satisfy my curiosity doing that. And I'm probably going to read up here on Sarah Gronert some more and see what kind of stats she has. and whether or not she's still playing tennis and competing in tennis, which I really hope she is. You know, I didn't want to make this a short video. I wanted a nice long 10, 11 minute video. And I'm not sure what else to say. You know, I hope you're still around because I haven't heard. You know, I hope you're okay. You know, I hope you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend if you happen to go that way. You know, because I don't know your preferences. I hope you have someone, you know, family that's supportive, friends that are supportive. And I hope, you know, you have a normal life or as normal as you can make it. Because, you know, not everyone does. You know, and I hope you stand up when someone makes some odd, you know, the remark. You know, rude remark, cruel remark. You know, I hope you stand up and, you know, be a little defensive and whatever else and tell them to bugger off, you know. Or learn just to ignore, you know. And there are women complaining, you know, how gifted you are and how much stronger you are, what advantages you have. Then start comparing, you know, stats with them. And see, you know, how much stronger you are, how much, you know, quicker you are, or whatever else. And actually see, you know, are you really that much better than all the other women you're competing against? Because I would bet that, no, you're competitive. And that's, you know, where you're at. Do as much as you can with your life. Don't let other people tell you what you can and can't do. You know, find your voice, your strength, and your courage, and you know, I actually want to see you play, you know, tennis, because usually watch tennis either. In fact, I don't usually watch sports at all because they don't really interest me anymore. Not that I've always been that way. I used to play soccer and baseball, but you know, my physical limitations after my back injury. You know, I'm happy I'm walking a mile, kind of thing. And probably push a mile and a half if I want to, if I slow down and take my time. Much more than that, and I end up bedridden. You know, to be extremely careful when I step. Otherwise, I'll sprain an ankle, kind of thing. Or a foot, you know. The bones over the arch of my foot. I you know, yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah, it's you know, I look up to you. I looked up to every professional athlete and professional period that's had a successful career. You know, who's managed to actually find a bit of happiness in their life and someone to love and care about, and you know, friends. I've got friends. You know, I've got extended family that accept me from who I am. I've got my little sister, you know, immediate family that accepts me from who I am. And unfortunately, the rest of my immediate family doesn't. You know, most of them don't like me speaking out and openly, and I'm doing it anyways. You know, it's part of me finding my strength and my courage and supporting other people, helping other people find out who they are and getting over the traumas that they face. You know, there's nothing wrong with being different, being intersexed, or having a genetic disorder that's not intersexed, you know, other conditions. You know, there's lots of people with you know, disabilities that are amazing, amazing people. And other genetic variations, you know, call midgets, dwarfism, the different degrees, and you know, there's some amazing people with Down syndrome, you know, that actually do quite a bit. You know, there's some totally astounding people with autism who have amazing gifts, you know, and I wish I could, you know, do a quarter of what they can do with their gifts, kind of thing, the talents that they have. You know, and it's like, just because we're a little different doesn't mean we're not human. We are. So remember, stay strong. So again, I hope you don't mind bringing this up. You may not want to hear it, but you know, sorry. It's I think it's needed. Take care.